बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। टुडेज़ लेक्चर इज़ ऑल अबाउट द ट्रांसपोर्टेशन ऑफ लार्ज मॉलिक्यूल्स एंड पर्टिकुलर मैटर। दिस में इंक्लूड डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ ट्रांसपोर्टेशन सिस्टम, द वेसिकल मीडिएटेड ट्रांसपोर्टेशन सिस्टम, एंडोसाइटोसिस एंड एक्सोसाइटोसिस। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल द वेसिकल मीडिएटेड ट्रांसपोर्टेशन सिस्टम इंक्लूड सम ऑफ द membrane or some of those forms made by the membrane which are going to be invaginated inside and causes the transportation of material from one side towards the other side. And this vesicle mediated transportation system could be endocytosis and exocytosis. Endocytosis happens when the endocytose material is going to be sent inside of the cell, like movement of the large molecules and particulate material across the cell membrane. This is about exocytosis as well as endocytosis. And example of these exocytosis or endocytosis are protein, hormones, immunoglobulins, LDL, viruses. These all are the examples of different types of vesicle mediated transportation system. Talking about first about the exocytosis, this is the release of the macromolecules to the exterior. As the name indicates, the movement of the material from inside towards the exterior of the cell. This process requires energy. This process may require calcium ions and cytoskeletal framework. Why energy? Because the macromolecules are going to be pushed out of the cell, that's why they need energy. And calcium ions are also the facilitator of this type of exocytosis. The fate of exocytosis material, it could attach to the cell surface and becomes peripheral proteins, antigens. It becomes a part of extracellular matrix. Extracellular matrix means those substances which are present in the material which are other than the cell, which are in conjunction with the cell, which are present outside the cell. So it may composed of collagen and glycose aminoglycans. Then it could be the sum of the molecules like hormones. The examples of hormones could be insulin, parathyroid hormone. It can enter the circulation and reach the target cells. So the fate of exocytosis material could be 3. It could attach the surface and action. It could be hormones, it could be ECM. Then comes the other types of vesicle mediated transportation system, which is endocytosis. It involves a continuous ingestion by the cells of their own membrane along with the material present on their outside. So the material present on the outside of the cell membrane could be internalized by the process of endocytosis. So just like the case of exocytosis, endocytosis requires energy, calcium ions, chondrotactic molecules like microfilament system. These are all the requirements for the endocytosis. And the endocytosis is further subdivided into two types, phagocytosis and pinocytosis. Types of endocytosis dependent upon the size of the material to be ingested. If it is solid, it could be categorized as phagocytosis, and it could be liquid in case of pinocytosis. It is non-selective fluid phase endocytosis, selective receptor mediated endocytosis. So endocytosis, phagocytosis means to eat. Ingestion of large particle like bacteria, virus, cell debris by macrophages. They extend pseudopodia and surround the particles to form phagosomes. Fusion of phagosome to form lysosome to form phagolysosomes. This is the overall process by which phagocytosis occurs. It is mainly done of the microbial species. As I told you, this could be bacteria, this could be viruses. So the process happens in case of endocytosis, it could be respiratory burst. The endocytosed material, the defective phagocytosed material may lead to different types of disease. The one type of disease could be chronic granulomatous disease. If the proper phagocytosis does not occur, it may lead to defective phagocytosis. The normal process of phagocytosis is the respiratory burst. it with the congestion by the help of oxygen, it is going to make superoxides and then forms the hydrogen peroxides, which is going to act as a antimicrobial effect. So this phagocytose material could be destroyed by the process of phagocytosis, and if it does not happen properly, then defective phagocytosis may lead to different types of disease. Then comes the pinocytosis, which is the uptake of extracellular material which is in liquid form. Some types of pinocytosis are also there. It could be random, it could be non-selective, it could be the uptake of solutes and active transport. So so the pinocytosis could be random, could be non-selective, could be uptake of solutes and active transportation. Receptor-mediated absorptive pinocytosis is the very important type of pinocytosis, also called as absorptive endocytosis selective. It is selective. It takes place by the coated vesicles and endosomes. Coated vesicles, when combined with the outside material, it may cause the formation of cladding proteins and carry the endocytosed material inside the cell. And then comes the endosomes, also called receptosomes. Receptosomes, why receptosomes? Because these are present on the receptor sites. When they are endocyte, they are called receptosomes. Do not contain hydrolytic enzymes having acidic pH. It separates ligands from the receptors with stimulus release of cladding. We will discuss the details of other types of pinocytosis in detail tomorrow, and with some types of the transportation mechanisms or phenomena.